Welcome back to the Aramco Group studio at UTTV. Seems like every day there's something new on the saga of Mayor Bob Filner. And yesterday it was probably, for me, the straw that broke the camel's back in terms of I can't take anymore. Enough is enough. Gloria Allred, you've now produced and talked with Peggy Shannon, the most delightful woman, and just her whole presentation. I was in tears at the end of this thing. I'm telling you, it was emotional. It was terrible to hear. She has to be the most courageous woman in this town coming forward like that.
Well, I do give a lot of credit to Peggy and also to the other women who have come forward. Yeah. Of course, also to Irene McCormick Jackson, my client who is suing Mayor Filner in the only sexual harassment lawsuit against him right now. And also to Michelle Tyler, who is the person who was caring for the American Marine injured in Iraq, who unfortunately Michelle was, she alleges, sexually harassed by the mayor in the mayor's office in City Hall. And all the other women, and it just, you know, it's hard to break silence, but it's long overdue for this to happen because the mayor needs to be accountable. And the only way he's going to be accountable is if people speak the truth to power and speak the truth to the mayor and let everybody know what's going on in San Diego.
Now they've done that, and you brought him forward, and, you know, you're pretty knowledgeable of Democratic Party politics. You pointed out yesterday, rightfully so, Barbara Boxer says go, Feinstein says go, Pelosi says go. All these Democrats say go. Why isn't he going?
Well, I guess only the mayor and or his attorneys can answer that. But individuals in power don't give up power easily. They fought for it, and maybe he's got economic reasons. Maybe he's got personal reasons. I don't know what his reasons are. But the handwriting has been on the wall for quite a while. The people of San Diego has had it up to here
and
beyond.
And beyond, absolutely.
He has to resign. It's the only way
to win
justice. What if he doesn't?
We're stuck with this. He doesn't have to. We'll get to it in a moment. Jan Goldsmith has another theory. We'll get to it in a moment. But right now, he doesn't have to.
Well, legally, on this day, he doesn't have to. But, you know, he didn't have to run for mayor either. And he needs to do the right thing and put the people first. And if he does the right thing and puts the people of San Diego first, he'll resign. And hopefully, at least his advisors can tell him that would be the best way for him and the people of San Diego.
No sign of that yet.
Well, you know, he's hired not just one, but two law firms to fight.
All kinds.
The good fight. We're ready for that battle. And we're going to fight him every inch of the way.
All right, Carl Luna, it strikes me that the only voice we haven't heard from is organized labor. Labor has been unbelievably silent about this. How much longer can they be silent?
At some point, one would imagine the Labor Council has to weigh in, particularly since so much of their membership happened to be women. And this is extremely damaging to the image of the party and to anybody who's associated with Bob Filner. If he goes down in all of this, he'll take those who were supporting him with him.
Well, implications for politics locally being what?
It could hurt the reputation of labor leaders. It could hurt their ability to field new candidates into elected office. It'll be used by opponents to candidates' labor supports until the cows come home.
Wow. All right, Jan Goldsmith. Now, yesterday you put out, among the other things that happened here, I got a memo from you saying that there was a Section 108 of the Charter which allows the City Council to seek from a court a declaratory relief, an order that Mayor Filner be stripped of his office. Tell me about that, and what's the factual basis for that?
Well, let me just say that we have a city charter that makes it very difficult to remove a mayor. In fact, it's easier to remove the President of the United States than to remove the mayor of San Diego. We have no impeachment provisions. All there is really a recall. And people have asked me to look through the charter and how can
people
this
from the city council?
People from the media, from the community, and the city council.
Is there another way?
Yeah. Legal way, since we can't have a coup d'etat. Although Gloria would like that. And I know
I
a few women
that.
Who would really like that. We believe in the rule of law. There are some provisions in our city charter having to do with removal of an officer of the city. And since we now have a strong mayor, the strong mayor is the chief executive officer under our charter and is subject to those forfeiture provisions. One of them is Section 108, which says that every officer who willfully allows unauthorized payment of city money is subject to removal from office.
Now, let me ask you about that. What do you think the factual basis is? I guess people have been guessing about this, but what do you think it is?
Well, since it's only been used once unsuccessfully years ago because it wasn't an officer, we have to borrow from other provisions of law, and unauthorized payment means exactly what it means. It's not authorized by the law or by the policies. And I'll give you some examples that could be a basis. For example, hiring your own lawyer, giving you legal advice, at city taxpayer expense through, as an employee. You can't do that. That violates our policies.
That's the chief of staff, Lee Burdick, you're
yes,
talking about?
Yes, okay. Yes. Who assists the private lawyers. Another would be Sun Road possibility. $100,000 comes in unauthorized, and $100,000 goes out of the city treasury unauthorized. Never sees the light of day of the city council. Another might be a trip to Paris, for example. Never heard anything about that. But charging over $30,000 to city expense, I have yet to see one thing that shows that this is any city business, any city interest was involved. In fact, I saw the draft of the speech in Paris, which was drafted by the Iranian group that he was visiting. They drafted the speech for their purposes. And then finally, what came to light recently during our investigation, and we did disclose to the public because it's PRA request, is the fact that he had a city credit card and racked up a lot of charges and never gave any backup material. And
which is required. You have to
which
have
is required. Yeah. And ultimately, the comptroller found out about $1,000 worth of personal charges that has never been reimbursed, and the city has paid.
Now, one or all of those, or any others, will now be, I take it that the city council, it's in their court to take your opinion, legal opinion, and these factual circumstances and decide whether they're going to take action under 108?
Yes.
When are they going to do that?
August 28th is currently set. We'll present the evidence. And they'll, like any client, they'll weigh the pros and cons, and we'll give pros and cons. If they decide to go forward, then we would file what's called a complaint and declaratory relief, which is entitled to priority. We would actually go down to the presiding judge and we'd ask for a relatively swift hearing. Now, this is due process, so it has to be respected, but a relatively swift hearing because
meaning
of the turmoil.
10 days?
Well, it's going to be up to the presiding judge, and okay. I wouldn't want to estimate that, but we would plead and say, look, our city is in turmoil, and this is really one of the few bases upon which the mayor can be removed.
And we think there's a judge with the backbone to take the factual circumstance and declare Mayor Filner is out of office?
Yes.
Lori Allward, what do you think about that?
Well, I think he knows the judges in San Diego better than I do. But I will say this. There's, of course, other things going on as well. For example, there is the criminal investigation by the San Diego Sheriff's investigators and with the Attorney General, in a sense, overseeing that investigation. And I guess the Attorney General will make a decision, hopefully soon, as to whether or not there is any basis for a criminal charge against Mayor Filner. If, as and when there were to be such a charge, if there were a felony or felony charges, if in fact he were convicted, I'm not convicting him before he has a trial.
Right.
I don't know
right.
if he's guilty of anything or not.
Do you have any sense of when?
Then definitely he would no longer be mayor. That, of course, would take a long time.
That would take a year.
It would, but it's just, I'm saying we can't ignore that that's in the mix. It may be that the FBI is also investigating. So we'll have to see. I think the mayor's in a world of hurt. He's got a world of trouble.
Do you have any more civil suits coming?
I only have one civil suit filed at this time.
Right. Do you have any more coming?
I never know what the future is going to bring.
Do you have any more press conferences in mind with more people, more women coming forward?
Nothing planned at this time, but every day is a new day
and a
new adventure.
You do get calls.
I definitely have had many more calls from women than the number of women who have come forward.
Okay.
In other words, I've had some calls where the women have not come forward, and I'm not going to say who else I may or may not represent at this time.
But the stories you're probably hearing are worse or the same sort of
thing?
Well,
I mean, you know, there are a lot of similarities.
Yep.
But all I'm saying is not every woman wants to be go public, and I support that, and I respect that, and whatever their decision is, for whatever reasons they have, that needs to be supported. But they did want me to know what is going on.
Carl, go ahead.
If I can add something on the forfeiture of office, there are legal mechanisms to remove him from office. And if the people of San Diego want him out of the office and the city council, he will be removed. Whether it be 108, recall, resignation, or the last resort is amend the city charter and remove him and give him the power of city council.
And the
mayor
says there'll be a march on Sunday at 2 p.m.
There'll be a march on Sunday at 2 o'clock to City Hall.
Outside of City Hall. Everyone, y'all should come.
We all should be there. Gosh, I want to be there. This is crazy.
Well, please do.
Carl Luna, thanks for coming in. I'm sorry we're running out of time. Lori Allred, thank you. Jan Goldsmith, Godspeed.